Amen.
Amen. I so like and say, what a day. And I'm sitting here and let the anointing come back and the anointings keep on flowing. What a blessing. I can still hardly stand, but I give God all the glory and the praise. Hallelujah for my leaders. Hallelujah. Who has asked me to come and bring the word to you tonight. So I am grateful and thankful unto them. For that. So we're going to give God praise for the word tonight. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Let us stand. I know the theme for the prayer conference is Isaiah 40:21. I will be coming back to that scripture. But the scripture the Lord gave me to focus on is in Ephesians 6, 10, and 11. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Verse 11, put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
Amen.
You may be seated. The Lord wants me to speak on intercession and also preparedness. How the intercessors, prayer warriors, many different names that we have for prayer, but all come back to we need prayer that gives us result.
Hallelujah.
Amen?
Amen.
And he said to me that the whole armor, not a half an armor, Apostle Paul says the whole armor. He didn't say the armor of God. It is the full armor. Amen?
Amen?
Too many prayer warriors, too many intercessors, too many, they call them prophetic watchmen or gatekeepers or so many different names, have holes in their armor.
All right.
They're full of holes. They're full of crack in their armor.
Come on.
And they're not prepared to go in the realm of the spirit to pray.
Hallelujah.
To deal with demonic forces in the spirit because their armor is full of holes.
Come on, Pastor.
And these armors must, those holes in the armors, they must be filled.
Yes.
What are some of the holes in your armors? Mm-hmm. Bitterness. Unforgiveness, hatred,
say it,
my God,
not walking in love. These are holes in your armor. How can you go in the realm of the spirit to break with half an armor? That's why you're hitting walls in the spirit. You cannot get a prayer through because of these holes. Preparedness. Ask God to forgive you. Forgive those who need to be forgiven.
Amen.
Because as the Lord has forgiven you.
Amen.
Because what's coming into this earth, God needs every single one of us who are calling themselves, we're warriors, intercessors, whatever, but he needs us to pray.
Yes.
So we must be prepared. Our spirit man must be prepared. Our soul must be prepared for him to use us for his will.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Preparedness. The second thing we need to do before we can get into intercession is to read the word. Because the word of God is the building block. It is foundational for prayer to be born So you must read the word. You must cleanse your mind, cleanse your spirit with the word of God. Hallelujah. Preparedness. Prepare your heart.
Yes.
Prepare your heart. Put on truth and honesty. Because you cannot go before God without being truthful, without being honest, because He knows what's in your heart, and you can fool God. You cannot fool God, intercessors. You cannot fool God, prayer warriors.
Amen.
You must put on truth and honesty. Preparedness. After you release what's in your heart unto the Lord, all those things that is boiling inside of you, that is not right with God, after you release it to God, you let people go, you let anger go, you let bitterness go. You prepare your heart.
Yes.
Then you can enter His gate with thanksgiving. And praise. Because too many people coming in and praising God, I'm praising God, and the heart is not right. They have half an armor on. And they're trying to enter the gate with thanksgiving and can't be praised. God says no. Prepare your heart.
Yes.
Next. Begin to worship Him after you've given all you. You praise the Lord. You know you are in right standing with the Lord. That's what He wants when He comes before Him. And you release people. You release those stuff that's in your heart. Amen?
Amen.
Then you can start to worship. You worship. You worship Him. You are preparing your spirit, man. Before you can go into intercession, prayer is you praying. Intercession starts with God and ends with God. That's why you cannot enter into His presence with half an armor on. Preparedness. Preparedness. I can tell you sometimes, even before you go to bed at night, you need to do that. Prepare yourself. Because God will wake you up in the middle of the night.
Amen.
Because there are 8 watches.
Yes.
8 watches prayer throughout 24 hours. So the 3rd watch of the night could be between 12 a.m. and 3 a.m. The 4th watch of the night is 3 a.m. until 6 a.m. God can wake you up. You could be in the bed and your spirit starts stirring up and you got to go and pray because God has an urgent need, an urgent call for you to pray.
Yes.
That's why you cannot go to bed angry with somebody.
Woo.
Because you're giving place to the devil.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And you must ask God, Lord, what do you want me to pray today?
Yes.
Who do you want me to pray for?
Yes.
What is in your heart today, Lord? Because it's not about you, it's about what God wants.
Yes.
What God wants you to pray for.
Amen.
So you ask Him, how do you want me to intercede today? How do you want me to do this, God? He's not there. He can hear you. He wants you to ask Him. What's in your heart? How do you want me to pray today? Is there somebody in need? Let my heart beat, be your heartbeat, God.
Glory, glory, glory.
The Bible said likewise. We do not know how we ought to pray for. That's in Romans 8:26. We do not know, but it is the Spirit Himself.
Yes.
We will make intercession for us with groaning that cannot be uttered. It is the Spirit who searches the heart and know what the mind of the Spirit wills. We make intercession for us according to the will of God.
Yes.
As you prepare your spirit, man, how do you know God called you to pray? How do you know God called you to intercede? Because if you follow those steps, hallelujah, you begin to feel a stirring up in your spirit.
Yeah.
You begin to feel God bringing image into your mind. Certain things becoming good to your mind. Maybe nations, maybe somebody, maybe something that he wants you to pray for that particular thing. So you must follow the leading of the Spirit of God, because he's studying in the intercession.
Yeah.
So you just got to be ready to go into the intercession. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As you begin to intercede, hey, glory to God. As you begin to intercede, glory to God. And you begin to go into the realm of the Spirit.
Yeah.
Glory to God. As you go into the realm of the Spirit, the battle begins. Pastor spoke about the fourth dimension. Is where the spiritual realm, where you're doing battle with demons. That's because you are in there, hallelujah. You're fighting demonic forces. You see why you have to be prepared. You see why you're reaching into a level God wants you to be. But you are fighting different forces.
Amen.
Amen. If you're not ready.
Amen.
If you're not ready, if you're not ready, you'll be in trouble.
Oh, yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You got to be ready. You got to be ready. Many, many times, I can tell you, sometimes I go to war. I go to different positions, not by my own doing. But sometimes I will go my hands, because it says your fingers, you train your fingers, hallelujah, to walk in your arm for battle. I will go into position in the middle of the night. I'm walking, I'm moving, I don't know what I'm talking about. Walking, I'm walking, I'm walking, hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Because he's calling me to pray. He's calling me to intercede. Somebody needs the prayer. So God, in his mercy, hallelujah, has called me to intercede, because he knows I wake up. Even if I'm in bed, I wake up to pray. I am available, God. Hallelujah. I'm sensitive to your spirit, God. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Then I will be obedient to pray.
Glory.
I will be obedient to pray. Here I am, Lord.
Yes.
Because he will do that to you. So if you're calling different titles, you're giving yourself different titles, God did not call you in.
Come on, Pastor.
So be careful with that.
Yes.
Because it has to be an anointing that goes along with it. If you're not anointed, but you know you're going to go in the Spirit and pray. I'm so God. I'm sorry for that. Let God anoint you for what he has called you to be.
Amen.
Do not wish I was like this person, that person. Be yourself and who God called you to be. Because he has every single one of us, he has anointed us for a particular plan, for a particular purpose, for a particular assignment. Not all intercessors are the same, because there are different levels depending on your calling. There are different prayer warriors depending on your calling. That's why the eagle, God uses the eagle, because there are different types of eagles. Not all eagles are the same. Not all intercessors are the same. I was doing, let me just speak to you about an eagle. An eagle, the eagle in the Philippines, is different. They're stronger. Okay. They're eagles in different parts. They're stronger. Mm-hmm. Let me read this to you. They can rip somebody's flesh. They're prey. They're muscular. powerful. They have claws, typically heavier than that of most birds. The bald eagles have very sharp beaks as well as claws to grab and prey other animals. Eagles are territorial. Intercessors are territorial. God may assign you different territories. So if another intercessor is going from some other place, coming in your territory to pray, God will assign that intercessor into this territory to pray.
My God.
Because your assignment is over there, not over here. Because he has anointed you for this particular area.
Amen.
This particular territory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Stellar Sea Eagle, which is the eagle from the Philippines, can lift up 13 pounds. They're very heavy. Very, very heavy. An eagle can soar in the spirit for 4 to 6 hours. And they never flap their wings and they glide.
Wow.
There is very low energy. Why is God comparing eagles with human? Because of their strength.
Yes.
Because of their strength. So if you're not ready in the spirit to be like the eagle, you'll be flapping your wings in the spirit. Because the eagle soar. They never flap their wings. So if you're not ready to go in the spiritual realm, oh, you're going to be flapping your wings. You're going to be flapping your wings. You're not going to be able to soar in the spirit. You're not going to be able to soar because you never prepared yourself. You didn't prepare yourself. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I know that may be tough. I don't know. But I got to pray. I got to preach.
Amen.
Or say what God give me. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So if God is saying to prepare yourself, that is because you know there's something that's not right.
Woo, come on, Pastor.
So he's sending the word to you tonight. So let every man do a self-examination of himself. That's why Paul said that. We have to check ourselves to see where we are. Because if God has anointed you for a particular assignment, or if you've called yourself, you have given yourself a title, so you must be prepared. You must be prepared.
Yes.
Before you can do what God has called you to do. No soldier go to war at his own expense. No soldiers go to war at his own expense. They were trained.
Yes.
A soldier is trained before they go to war.
Yes.
So the same training that a soldier received in a natural, in the spiritual, where God has called us to be soldiers in the army of the Lord, there has to be some kind of preparedness. There has to be some kind of training.
Amen. Amen.
See, it's parallel. The natural, the spiritual, the spiritual, the natural.
Yes.
Same thing. Preparedness. Because in the realm of the spirit, when you face a lot of different forces, you better be on the lookout in the spirit, because it's like a sniper coming at a soldier. So you must be in position when they're coming to attack, so that you can pray, so that you can intercede, because the Holy Ghost himself will lead you to pray. Not to enter into certain areas to pray where he didn't call you to go into those areas.
Right.
That's where the danger is.
Yes.
People of God, intercession is no joke.
No, it's
Amen.
Not.
Amen.
No, it's not.
No.
No, it's not.
We have to be ready.
Yes.
We have to be prepared ourselves. So take this seriously.
Oh, yeah.
Take your prayer life seriously.
Oh yes.
If you are an intercessor, God called you to intercede. Listen to this and be prepared. Because when the hour is coming, when it's going to need you,
yes.
It's gonna lead you. You don't have time to say, okay, Lord, hold on a second. I'll be right back. But you should have been prepared. When you get up in the morning, you prepare. When you go to bed at night, before you go to bed, you prepare yourself.
Amen.
Because you never know when you're gonna be called.
Amen.
By God.
Amen.
To intercede for somebody. That's why he said, you are his battle axe. In Jeremiah, let's see what it says about Jeremiah 51. Said you are his battle axe. Amen. And weapons of war. For with you, listen to this. He said, with you, with nobody else, he says, with you, I will break the nations in pieces. With you, I will destroy kingdoms. Which means God needs us as his battle axe because he's going to use us to do those things. So when you go into war, that's your axe. You go in there. You worry. You cut it down. Everything that God did not plant, when you cut it down to the root, hallelujah, you're putting those things down. That's why you worry.
Yes.
That's why you worry in the spirit. That's why he said to a battle axe, an axe is coming. Hallelujah. You're cutting those things. Your mouth is full of the word of God. Your mouth is full of the wisdom of God. Your mouth. Intercessors are called watchmen.
Yeah.
Why are you called a watchman? God called you a watchman. Because you are there. You're on the wall. Watching. When attacks are coming. When attacks are coming against your leaders.
Yes.
So you are the one who have to watch for them. That's why he said that you are a watchman on the wall. Who's coming against your family members?
Yes.
Who's coming against your church? Who's
yes.
coming against your leader? Who's coming against your children? Who's coming against them? Who's coming to get the things that God has given you? Who's coming so you are a watchman on the wall?
Glory. Amen.
You're a watchman on the wall.
Amen.
Pushing away the attacks. Pushing away the plans of the enemy, because his plan is to kill, is to destroy. That is his plan. But God said, I come to give you life, life more abundantly. And when you are doing the will of God, and you are walking in righteousness with him, hallelujah, he will release the angel as you intercede. He will release warfaring angels on your behalf. He will release his fire on your behalf to destroy the forces of evil that is around you. That's why when you intercede, you sow it. Continue to sow. Don't stop sowing in the spirit. Because that's the purpose of him. That's why he used the eagle. That's why he used the eagle. Because an eagle is always prepared to soar. But let me ask you a question. All of you, you are intercessors. All of us, including myself, we are always. Are we all ready to soar?
Amen.
Are we all ready to soar in the spirit?
Hallelujah. Oh, glory.
When God called you to pray, when God called you to intercede, can you soar like the eagle? Can you soar like the eagle? Where you're not going to flap your wings, but you're going to compass things in the spirit, forces of evil, forces of darkness, so you're going to know that God got my back.
Yes.
His angels have been released to shield and protect me in the spirit. Can you do that?
Yes.
Can you do that?
Yes. Amen.
And as you continue to soar, God himself knows when he's going to end the intercession.
Amen.
Because when you're beginning to feel a rejoicing in your spirit, man, when you begin to laugh in the spirit, when you begin to sing in the spirit, which is called a note of praise, that's when you know you got a breakthrough in the spirit. That's when you know your Father has healed your prayer. Your Father's heart has been touched by your intercession.
Yes.
Because you are rejoicing.
Yes.
You are rejoicing.
Yes.
So God has ended that intercession.
Yes.
Now you glide. Isaiah 40:31 says, but those who wait on the Lord,
amen,
shall renew their strength.
Yes.
They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not go weary. They shall walk and not faint. As I was reading it, the Holy Spirit says to me, this scripture, but those who wait on the Lord, it is those who remain in the presence of God.
Yes.
This is what this scripture is. Those who wait in the presence of God, which means after you finish praying, hallelujah, nobody, even somebody come to lay hand on you to give you back your strength. No man can give you back your strength. Only the Holy Ghost can give you back your strength. That's why it says, you stay in his presence. Then I wait in his presence. He will renew your strength. He will empower you with strength. He will bring your virtue back to you. Men cannot give you back your virtue. I said, oh. Because many times I see people praying, or after they finish preaching or what have you, people will go to them and lay hand on them, trying to pray their strength back, trying to pray their virtue back. God said, you gotta stay in my presence. Stay in my presence. Holy Ghost will strengthen you. He will continue to strengthen you. Then be ready to soar again like the eagle. This is what the scripture means. He said, they shall mount up with wings like eagle. So as you strengthen, as you strengthen your inner man, so you're going to soar again. You're going to soar. Be prepared for the next battle. He said, you shall not run. You shall run. You're not going to go weary because the Holy Ghost strength is in you. That's why men cannot give you your strength back. Hallelujah. Because of his strength that he placed in you, you're going to be able to run. You're not going to go weary. You're not going to get tired because of Holy Ghost power, the Holy Ghost strength has strengthened your inner man.
Yes.
I said, that's what. So he opened up my eyes to really look at that scripture. I'm like, but those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. And I kept looking at it. Oh my God. God, he's going to renew you. Man can renew you. Are you hearing me?
No.
He was breaking down that scripture to me. Men cannot renew you.
No.
Men cannot give you the indwelling, the infilling of the Holy Spirit. Only him can.
Yes.
So the scripture says, he's giving you some refreshing. Men cannot refresh you. Men cannot refresh you. Only him can refresh you.
Yes.
Glory. Only him. And the only way you're going to get that is by remaining in his presence.
Oh, Jesus.
Glory. Glory. Glory to God. So as I continue, I say, okay, Holy Ghost, I feel like just got to mess me up because I'm looking at the scripture here. I'm like, okay, tell me more, oh God. Tell me more about that with you, oh God. Oh God, now I'm going to do something different, oh God. I know when I finish intercession, I got to go up the threshing floor and stay down as I glide and stay down, hallelujah, for God to refresh me, for God to renew me So it was a whole different light as he was revealing those things to me in the scripture. I said, oh, it really makes sense. Yes. You're telling the Holy Spirit, I said, oh, it really makes sense. But those who we stay and remain with the Lord, you're going to give me my strength back, yes. God. You're going to give me my virtue back, God. Hallelujah. Because of what you're going to bless me, the strength going to bless me, I can run over a troop.
Yes.
I can leap over a wall.
Hallelujah. Glory.
Because now I got the strength of an eagle.
Yes.
Oh, Jesus.
Yes.
Ah!
Yes.
Ah! Because he said, they shall mount up with wings like eagle. After he strengthened you. Mm-hmm. After he strengthened you.
That's it.
Then you're going to be the eagle.
That's it.
My God. Jesus. Jesus. Oh my God, as I continue to read, I said, oh God, tell me more about that scripture, God. Open up my spiritual eyes. Open up my spiritual ears that I may be able to see what the natural eyes cannot see. That I may be able to hear what my natural ears cannot hear. But my spiritual ears, through your revelation, can hear about the scripture. Now I have more understanding of what I'm to do with the scripture. Because he's saying it. I'm going to act differently. I'm going to do things differently. Because of what he has revealed to me in the scripture. And I'm here to share it with you. Because all of us here, all of us are in the battle. We all of us have been enlisted.
Yes.
We are all soldiers,
yes,
in the army of the Lord.
Yes.
So if he says something to me, he reveal it to me, and it's making sense to me, I pray that it makes sense to you also.
Yes.
Because I've read the scripture many times. Never have I understood what this scripture really meant. So I'm sharing it with you. You may receive it, you may not receive it. You can bring it before the Lord. He will explain to you the way he wants to explain it to you. Amen?
Amen.
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 So people of God, which is my time, people of God, be serious about your prayer life. Prayer life is a lifestyle. It is a lifestyle for Christians. You don't pray, little power. You pray, the more you pray, the higher your ranking in the spirit. The more you pray, the more God position you in the spirit. Because he has given all of us authority to tread on serpent and scorpion, over all the powers of the enemy. He has given it to all of us. But it is up to us to know what you're going to do with that authority. It is up to us to know what you're going to do with that power that he has placed inside of you. When you pray, you change things. Prayer causes acceleration to the things that have been stagnating in your life. It brings speed. Hallelujah. Prayer with your relationship with God, communication with your Father. Prayer change your ranking. Prayer bring you closer to God. Prayer, when you pray unto him, you get answers. You get answers. So people of God, as I said, continue to pray. Take what I said. You want to follow those steps, it's up to you to follow them. But try not to go before God, full of garbage in your heart,
amen,
with your half and armor on. It's not going to work.
Amen.
It's not going to work. You cannot fool God. Remember that. He knows your heart.
Yes.
He knows your thought. Before you even open up your mouth, He knows what you're thinking. So He sent this word to you tonight because it's getting you ready for what it's going to do with your lives. So prepare yourself to receive what thus says the Lord. Amen. Amen.